Hi, I'm Karen McKee. Welcome to my channel on scientific writing. Today we're going to talk about paragraphs. You've probably not thought a lot about how paragraphs are structured, but writing strong paragraphs will go a long way toward making your narrative flow well. If you are struggling to write your thesis or dissertation or your first journal article, you may find that paying attention to paragraph structure will make your writing more coherent and cohesive. In this video, I'm going to show you how to write a strong paragraph and also show you some examples of problem paragraphs that you should avoid. The paragraph is an important unit of any narrative. Well-written paragraphs organize your thoughts and help the reader digest your information. There is no set length because this depends on what you need to say to get your idea across. There are three main parts to a paragraph: the topic sentence or heading, the body, and the conclusion. The topic sentence states the topic of the paragraph. In some cases, there may be two or three sentences needed to explain the topic, especially in long paragraphs. In the body of the paragraph, the topic idea is fleshed out with examples, evidence, and/or reasoning. The conclusion, which may be one or more sentences in length, wraps things up and may point out the significance of the information presented. Let's look at an example of a paragraph and examine the three main parts. This paragraph is from a paper describing the effects of vegetation structure on hurricane sedimentation in coastal wetlands of the Mississippi River Delta. The first sentence is the topic sentence and tells you what the paragraph is going to be about. Hurricanes and other storms, such as winter cold fronts, play an important role in promoting wetland sedimentation in the Mississippi River Delta complex from distant sources, such as coastal bays and lakes or offshore. This topic sentence tells the reader that the paragraph is about how hurricanes are important in delivering sediment to wetlands in the Mississippi River Delta. Each paragraph should have only one topic, and everything in it should be related to that topic. So the rest of the paragraph should support this statement by providing reasoning, evidence, or examples of sedimentation by hurricanes. In this case, the body of the paragraph consists of examples of hurricane sedimentation from the literature. Several studies have documented hurricane-induced sedimentation in coastal marshes of the Mississippi River Delta complex. For example, Hurricanes Katrina and Rita caused an average deposition of 5 centimeters of sediment in wetlands across coastal Louisiana and eastern Texas in 2005. Furthermore, the sediment delivered by Hurricane Katrina slowed elevation loss in subsiding brackish marshes in the Mississippi River Delta complex, demonstrating the positive effects of storm deposits. And the paragraph continues with several more examples of hurricane and sediment studies. The paragraph concludes with a sentence that explains the significance of the preceding text and ties back to the topic sentence. These investigations together indicate that hurricane-delivered sediments can have positive effects on marsh resilience and ultimately sustainability. So this paragraph provides a basic overview of how hurricanes might influence sedimentation in these wetlands using examples from the literature. But that's not the only way to write a paragraph. You might, for example, need to take a different approach to building a paragraph depending on what you're trying to say. Here's another paragraph from the same paper that provides the reasoning for the study. In this case, there is not a single topic sentence, but two sentences that introduce the idea that different types of vegetation may have different effects on sediment deposition. The subtropical climate of the Mississippi River Delta complex supports both salt marsh and mangrove vegetation in the most seaward wetland zones. Because marsh and mangrove vegetation differ substantially in above-ground structure, their capacity to accumulate hurricane-generated sediment may also differ. What follows is the development of this idea and leads to the reason for the study. Global changes in sea level, atmospheric CO2, temperature, and storm activity may promote shifts in plant species dominance in subtropical wetlands, with consequences for coastline stability, primary production, food web support, and other functions. Examination of hurricane sedimentation where salt marsh and mangrove distributions overlap can provide insights into whether vegetation shifts will alter coastal vulnerability to sea level rise and other global factors. In other words, studying how vegetation type influences sediment capture during a hurricane may shed light on how shifts in vegetation caused by climate change may alter sediment accretion to counterbalance sea level rise. The paragraph conclusion wraps things up by pointing out the lack of studies comparing the capacity of marsh versus mangrove vegetation to capture hurricane sediment. This paragraph's intent is to explain why the study was needed and points ahead to the objectives of the study presented later in the narrative. Although there is still a three-part structure, this paragraph is built differently from the previous one. Each section of your paper may lead to different paragraph configurations. You might be presenting a knowledge gap in the introduction, describing an experimental system in the methods, comparing things in the results, making an argument in the discussion, or synthesizing information in the conclusion section. Each of these aims will lead to a slightly different sentence arrangement and overall paragraph construction. The point to keep in mind is that each paragraph should focus on a single topic, and all sentences should relate to that topic and support the assertion made in the topic sentence or sentences. Let's now look at some problems with paragraphs. One common problem is that the paragraph contains more than one topic. Consider this example. Pause the video to read it. This paragraph covers multiple topics: sediment deposition and wetland elevation, hurricane-induced erosion and habitat loss, and human activities altering sediment delivery. These ideas are related but should be separated for clarity. The solution is to split the paragraph into two or more paragraphs and focus on only one topic in each one. Here is one way to do this. Pause the video to read. Now each paragraph has a clear and distinct focus. The first paragraph explains the beneficial effects of sedimentation. The second paragraph discusses the destructive impacts and human influence. And there is a logical progression from one topic to the next. Another problem is no topic sentence. The first sentence may refer to the previous paragraph instead of setting forth the topic of the current paragraph. Or the topic may contain a series of sentences, none of which state the overall point that the writer is trying to make. For example, this paragraph lacks a topic sentence. Pause the video to read it. The paragraph jumps straight into details without introducing the main idea. It lacks a guiding statement to help the reader understand the paragraph's purpose, and the relationship between the ideas is not immediately clear. Let's now read the paragraph with a topic sentence. The topic sentence clearly establishes the main idea. The rest of the paragraph logically follows from the topic sentence. The relationship between sedimentation's benefits and drawbacks is introduced up front. Another problem is that a paragraph intended to explain something may lack a logical flow. The sentences don't really build on each other, and the paragraph lacks coherence. Consider this paragraph. It lacks a clear focus on hurricane sedimentation and wetlands. It introduces unrelated ideas such as infrastructure damage, displaced communities, and general hurricane impacts. The transition between ideas is weak, making it difficult to follow. The last sentence abruptly shifts to scientists studying these processes without connecting it well to the rest of the paragraph. Here is a revision that flows better and has a stronger conclusion. It maintains a clear focus on hurricane sedimentation and wetlands, and each sentence logically connects to the next, improving flow. It also avoids unrelated topics such as infrastructure damage and community displacement, and concludes with a statement that ties back to the significance of the topic. Each paragraph in your paper should build upon the previous paragraph and move your scientific story forward. If a paragraph doesn't seem to advance the story, you need to look at it carefully and see if it has any of the problems I just covered. I think you'll find that writing strong paragraphs will greatly improve the quality and flow of your narrative. Thanks for watching, and please subscribe or leave a comment if you found this video helpful.